Hey, this is Ella Smith at American Cannabis Company. I hope you all are well. Thanks for tuning in. I want to talk to you today. This is kind of our part two of what it takes to get into the cannabis business. And this is about raising capital. First and foremost, put this disclaimer out there. At ACC, we do not raise capital. We do help clients put together tools that go out and raise capital, but we do not raise capital. I want to put that disclaimer out there. What I do recommend is you hire a lawyer that can help you put together the necessary tools from your PPM, your private placement memorandum, to your safe harbor information on your pitch decks, and really help and give you that guidance so that you can follow these properly. I see a lot of people out there sending out quite a bit of pitch decks that are really illegal and they should be reported. We don't do that, but just know that you will get tracked down by doing this if you're not doing it properly. So I just recommend, once again, hire a lawyer, have you do this. But at ACC, and what we do is we help put together these tools so that you can work with your lawyer and go out and raise capital and put together the right information. So these pitch decks are really evolved around a full blown business plan, which usually anywhere from 60 to 100 pages. And then also a pro forma model that really is gonna break down the business from all the capital expenditures, operational expenditures, what the ROIs look like over time, and really give you those details. Then we can extrapolate a lot of that information down into a very shorter version of a pitch deck that can be used to be put out. So these are the things that we do to help put together the tools for our clients that have gone out and raised millions and millions of dollars over our time in business here. And so for you, it's a matter of putting those tools together and then going and finding those resources. There's many different ways to get capital. There's debt and there's equity and there's a combination of both you can do. And so you have to understand what works best for you. A lot of people don't understand that, you know, you've got this great idea, you want to start a business, and you put together these tools, and you think, oh, I need to go raise $10 million. I'm only willing to give up 10 or 15%, you know, of equity in order to raise this capital. Well, you're never going to get funded that way. And people need to come to the reality that you will potentially give up control of that business and lose that and have a minority stake in the business just to get that capital raised. And that's pretty common, you'll see across the space. So hire a good lawyer and give them the guidance. Hire a consulting firm that will put together these tools with you, or a legal team could do that for you as well. And go out and just tap the capital markets and see what's available to you as far as all the different resources from private money, public money. There's all kind of family money.